Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today we are going to learn how to make a mask armature or the foundations for a mask. So this is all just made from cardboard, tin foil, and tape. And then afterwards, we can cover the whole thing with plaster and then paint it. Okay, so I'm gonna start out with just my piece of cardboard, and I wanna give it a little bit of shape. A little bit of a shape of a face. So as you can see, I'm just taping, and I can even look and I can sort of form it to my face and see how curved do I want the cardboard to be. But more or less, that's probably good. So once I have the cardboard shape, then I can start drawing the face on the cardboard. So in this case, I just need to draw out the eyes. I could draw where the nose is. Clearly I'm not gonna draw the ears. Oh, I also wanna cut the underside of the jawline or the bottom part of the face, of the mask. So I think I'll just start out with doing that. So
so long since life felt new, a change of place might help go new. The smoggy gray that hides the blue, but oh, what a ray of light might do. It cuts through clouds and grows the trees. It never rains in Southern California. Just kidding, it does sometimes, but not for long before sunshine. Encourage you to exercise your mind. Deep as you can go and high as you can climb. Somebody's got to save the art. It's unsafe schools and unsafe parks. Shanty towns and project homes. Inside the family, love still strong. Cause even in my hood, the light shines through. But oh, what a coat of paint might do. What's there for the ghetto youth if there's no means to express who they are and what they go through? Right path chosen from far too few. We know what we think.
The mystery is no longer a mystery. So all you need is cardboard, tin foil, tape, scissors. So really I'm just trying to make something that is strong enough that I can add the plaster to, and make sure that, you know, everything is attached and is sturdy so that when I add plaster to this, it will not fall apart. Okay, so you can make any kind of different features you want. I particularly just like the look of a beak and the look of the big ears. So I'm not really going for one particular animal, but just something that is visually striking, something that's really interesting. And then after I paint it, I can add another element to it that will give it a lot of life and depth and something that is going to be really interesting, maybe even a little scary. Okay, all right, thanks.